So I'm Hope. I'm here with the amazing Miss Julia. And hello. And Julia has these awesome Right Voice for You classes coming up at Rotary Summer Camp. And I was just telling her, I work as an actress, and I was just telling her this fun story that I had about judgment and kind of the realization early on about like so ultimately it's like why not to take yourself that seriously as an actor in the auditioning room. But then also as anybody anywhere in the world, whether you're on a date or in a business meeting or anything. And I was like, wait, we should record this. So
yeah.
Did you have anything you want to say before I
dive in? No, I want to hear your story.
And so I was telling Julia, so I've worked as an actor. I mean, I was doing like school plays and things when I was really young. And then when I got to college, I majored in drama, which is my favorite thing to say, because I think it's hilarious. I'm a bona fide, I have a BA in.
I'm a certified drama queen. I like it.
I have a Bachelor of Arts with honors in drama, you guys.
that is funny.
Anyway, so I was just saying that when I started auditioning, I had this really cool experience, and I'm so grateful to this director and the universe, and like just for conspiring to get this message to me really early on. I had this audition, can't even remember, it was like a Money Tree commercial. I don't know if you had those, but it's like where you can like, and anyway, I had this audition for this thing called Money Tree. And I got a SU audition, and then the next round is called the callback, where usually you're in the room with like the director and the producers and maybe the writer and the client in a commercial setting. And that's where they're like, okay, we liked you a lot, and now we're just kind of matching people. And I had a really fun time, didn't book the role. I got put on hold, which means that they were extra considering me. That's when it's down to like maybe two or three people, and they're just, you know, they're like holding you for the dates, but they haven't booked you yet. And then I got released. Cool, whatever. I was just excited. I've been put on hold. I was brand new. I mean, I think I had just started auditioning like in this world. So a few months later, I run into the director of this commercial at a networking happy hour. And he comes up to me. I didn't even remember him at first, because a lot of times like I go into the auditioning room and it's just like there are so new people, new faces. So I didn't recognize him at first, and he introduced himself and was like, oh, I was this director on this commercial. And he was like, I just want to let you know, I fought for you tooth and nail. It was like people climbing on the table, like fighting for who would get the role. And it came down to the fact that there was only one guy that we liked for the role, and he was also blonde, and it would look like you guys were siblings and not like boyfriend, girlfriend.
And so it's like, yeah, incestuous looking.
Yeah, they didn't want it. They needed it to be clear that they were like boyfriend, girlfriend, not brother, sister. And it was such a gift. Like, I'm still so grateful for that moment, because it was such a gift just to be like, it isn't about you. Like, at the end of the day, like, it isn't about you. I could have gone in there, I could have done everything perfectly. But because I didn't have, you know, the right hair color or whatever, or I looked too much like, and even then it was like, if they had had another guy that they liked who had a different hair color, I might've been cast. So like, it was like, and you can mind trip over that.
That like goes totally to like the, you know, the 10 commandment of access, no form, no structure, no significance, because we go into those auditions and we make every single move we make so significant
all the time.
And it has nothing to do with you. But like, you're already usually in or out by the time they see your face.
Yes. That's the other funny thing about it too. Like, I have, like, if I'm being totally honest, I've torn into myself as an actor, like with my talent, like, because there was like, I wasn't booking as much as I wanted to or whatever, and I was just so hard on myself and thought I was such a terrible actor. And then and then it took a while of people being like, you're so talented, like what are you, like, get out of your head, like all this stuff, for me to finally get back to that moment of just like, that's right, it's not about me. I could be the best actor in the world, but they like her nose better. And then even that, like, don't make that about you either, because you're, you know, the more that you let that get to you, again, any setting, whether it's in dating or business or walking down the street, like, the more we're trying to, like, reflect and deflect all these judgment.
Yeah, and then it's like the thing, the reason that some of the greatest actors get cast is because they have a huge sense of their being. And every time you judge yourself, you eliminate your sense of your being.
Yeah.
So yeah. That's awesome. Thank you for that story.
Hi, you're welcome.
Yeah. And so this actually leads into, I just want to mention this.
Yeah, go for it.
Doing a Right Voice for You summer camp that's 7 parts. And one of them is called Authentic Auditioning. So it's not just for actors. It's also about how to receive judgment of any kind and be you in the world. But thank you, Hope, for that story, because it really is this place where we think that our life and exactly how we do things is so significant and so important, and we judge ourselves to a pulp in business, in being a facilitator, in being an actor, in being a mom, in getting yourself out there. And it's like, that's not actually it at all. It's like, what are you already being? That's a gift. So thank you so much for that story, Hope.
You're so welcome. Yeah. I'm so grateful you said that too, because yeah, anybody who sees that title and is like, oh, I'm not an actor, I'm not a performer, I'm not a, you know, whatever, it's not for me. I've taught classes before, like, about acting, but to just everyday people, because I think I've mentioned this to you, like, acting is about being. And so at the end of the day, like, it doesn't matter where you're coming from. I'm so grateful that, like, this is where I happened to end up, where I chose to end up in my life, because the number of lessons that I learn about being more of me as whoever I am by acting has just changed so much.
Totally, totally. Yeah. Awesome. Well, thank you for being here. And thank you, everybody, for listening. And we'll see you next time. Bye.
Thank you, guys. Bye.